Well, hello there once again from the 29th Winter Universiad. We are in Krasnoyarsk, Russia, in the heart of Siberia, at the Sopka Cluster, a venue that has had its fair share of drama and excitement. And this day should be no different than any other. It's a slope-style snowboard finals. We are about to see what some of our best snowboarders have to offer. But the ladies, slope-style will get us underway, followed by the men's. There are six females left in the competition, 12 men's. Each competitor will have two runs at this course that's made up of different features. Top score takes the win. Weather conditions, partly cloudy, very cloudy actually, and the light becoming quite flat with visibility. There is a slight wind as well, which will make it slightly more difficult for the riders on the course. Visibility imperative in a sport like this one. The course has two jump features and two jibbing features. That's the rails or features of a similar style. And slope style is about the overall impression on the judges. Completing the course, every different feature is key. One mistake means you will be marked down, and the judges are looking for the deal. They're looking for the rider that goes difficult while also being fluid. They're looking for riders that execute, that show big amplitude and also a good landing as well. Katerina Kozova from Moscow State University came 11th in this competition in 2015. 16th in the World Cup in Italy this season, so she's in fairly good form, the Russian here. After performing in the qualification really nicely, taking a fourth with a score of 59.50. She does the same again here. She's going to go to the top of the leaderboard. And the first rider to stick to the middle of the course to start with, going a little bit more simplistic on the rails. Starts off with a 50-50 before coming off a little bit early. Board slide on the down rail. And she goes back to the down rail on the left-hand side. So far, so good. A little 180 off as well. Front side five so far, pretty huge from the Russian. And a backside three as well. We're gonna have a new leader. Showing the judges that she spins both ways. Front side is where you spin with your upper body facing down the hill. Backside is where you show your back to the crowd. We've seen both from the Russian. Stylish as well. Katerina Kozova has come to party. 68.75. Lizaveta Bogdanova. Three students from Moscow in a row. Eighth on the half pipe. Top tens on the Europa Cup as well. Last result was in the Netherlands. Took a sixth there, going for the 50-50, trying to work the board all the way over the rails. So far, so good for Russia. And what they'll feel is if they can land their first run and get a score on the leaderboard, the pressure's really going to be off of them second run. The 180 to start with. Bogdanova on the Buda goes for the 360 second time around, but that's stylish. Slow spinning, but really holding on to the board for long periods of time. We're just about to see what the judges are really valuing out there today. Not as big on the spin chart. Holding the grab for days, though.
And nice landing. Perfect. So
it's 65 for Elisaveta Bogdanova. Russia 1-2-3. Anastasia. Logging over. From Ekaterinburg in Russia. Third in this competition in Kazakhstan 2 years ago. A nose grab and a 360. Won that bronze medal in Almaty. We're going to see how she's progressed over the past 2 years. She's trying to get creative off the side hits. She goes onto the down rail. Two Budas left. First one's the front side three. Crowd starting to become animated here. Two threes in a row. Front side, back side. From Loganova. Anastasia. Loganova. Second place, Russia, top four positions. They've come out firing here on home snow. Sarah Hartz from Germany, fifth in the half pipe. This is where it gets interesting. 75.75, the score to beat for the riders as the snow starts to come down a little heavier than in run one. Sarah Hartz straight off the rainbow rail. Checking her speed into the second feature. Looks like she's looking for a board slide. 50-50. Simple work so far, but effective. Holding out the grab. Last booter for the German. Trying to improve on a score of 30.50. Goes for the 180, bounces it. Struggles for speed to get over the flat. But gets her work done for the day. Coming off early. On that down rail. Improvements, 35 from the German, stays in sixth place. Noemi Akui. Cessny, Seku University. Looking to improve on a score of 40. Her and five features stand in the way of that. The French rider. Based in Chambéry. Fourth and a fifth this season in the Europa Cup. Front side three. Coming into the final jump feature. And a backside three as well, so spinning both ways and pressing the judges. We'll be happy with that. Will it improve the score of 40? We're about to find out. The clean work on the upper section. Stomping her run. And her work is completed for the day. She can be really pleased with how she's qualified for the top six.
Absolutely not there, but everything will depend.
Noemi Akui. Best run of 49. That's an improvement for the French rider. Good job. Just about getting better all the time, improving scores. Elena Kostenko. another rider from Moscow, a second in this competition in the Big Air 2 years ago, a seventh in the half pipe. Now she's the leading lady of this competition. 75.75 is her score, and this is her chance to increase her lead and put herself in pole position for gold here at the Winter Universiade. So far, so good. The pressure is almost off of the leader. Big off the first one, but the landing's a little bit to be desired. It's lacking. Second boot to them. That time going on the front side. Looks like a front side five. Trying to go as colossal as possible. Clean work on the rails. About 2-4 rotations first up. Just getting it round. That one just dropping short of a 5.40. Almost. Currently though, 75.75. And she's beaten it, 76.75. Kostenko extends her lead. The execution was better than the first run. So the ladies' slopestyle results. Russia take the podium. Elena Kostenko, Nastasia Loganova, and Ekaterina Kosova. They take four of the top six places. Vlad Hardarin from Russia. Someone who's known all over the world for his ability to score high in these contests. Second in the Youth Olympic Games in Norway, that's back in 2016. Took a top 20 in the Olympic Games as well, and will be one of Russia's favorites to take gold here, although early on he didn't have it all his own way through qualification. Didn't score as high. So far, looking immaculate though. Massive! Goes absolutely massive off the top. Second feature. Four rotations. It's a 14. And we are gonna have a new leader, surely. Saving his best until the finals. Four rotations locked down. .92 is the reward. Leading by a mile, Vlad Hardarin. You can see why. He went massive. Sasha Badiko, okay, the University of Grenoble. Frenchman looking towards his second run. Fourth place, just outside the medal. 67.75, but needs to try and find 7 or 8. That's an upgrade on this run to get on the podium. Really has to go for broke now. Off the down rail. The execution here has to be on point. Going for the backside 9, but he's gone a little bit early as well. The execution, the landing, not quite there. And then a 7 to finish. Balico can be really pleased with what he's tried to achieve. Big hugs all round. 74.25 will get the Frenchman into the podium positions. He feels, we can see his body language, slightly frustrated after not sealing the 9. Clean work on the 7 to come here has performed really well. He's done his country proud just by 0.50, but no improvements on the placing. Fourth place for Sasha Malikov. Martin Kisha from the Czech Republic, looking like a superhero, but he really needs to take off here. Kisha currently in the bronze position, 74.25. Someone who's taken a bronze in this event, in the big air and the slope style 2 years ago. Working the down rail. Almost a hand drag there. Any time the control's lost, you'll be marked down. Nice start on the first there. Huge! Three full rotations. 1080 stopped it. He's left everything out there.
Woohoo! Parada.
Holds the grab for long periods of time. The execution's good. So stylish. The judges are going to reward this. Does it get up to silver? Maybe. Is it as big as Vlad Harderin's first run of 92? Who knows? But it's going to challenge the podium again. Second, he goes up one. 86.50 for Martin Mikishka. Great work. Anton Mamayev. Currently sitting in 10th position, wearing BIM 22, the national champion from 2016. Not competing so much on the World Cup or Europa Cup anymore. Best result was in 2013 at Europa Cup with a 14th place, but being a Russian national champion means you can run. Goes for the triple, lands it. If he can stop this one, we might have a new man on the podium. Does, slight hand drag, but what a run. The crowd's responding, but now it's down to the judges. 10th place, Anton Mamayev. From the first run, a score of 26.25, but he has just absolutely nailed it. Off axis three times. Went for broke the first time. Same the second time round, but how does that compare to Vlad Harderitz? 92. The crowd looking on. They've seen something very special. Russia, Czech Republic, Finland so far. Have we got a new gold medal contender? Yes, 95 is a reward for throwing a triple. New leader, Mikhail.
Okay, man, you can go.
Matveev, another Russian rider, fourth in this competition, 2015. Has won the big air and the slopestyle last time out in Almaty in Kazakhstan. But he has to improve here if he wants a medal. He's currently in 12th position, and all the big names have really come to the forefront of this event. There's frustration already. He goes big, goes off axis twice off the first jump feature, and stops the second landing. Frustration, though, for Mikhail Matveev at the top of the run. We'll have to wait to see if Russia will have a 1-2-3. And it's a third, Russia have got the podium. Mikhail Matveyev rewarded for going humongous. Axel Tellen from Finland, the final rider to go. Russia currently have 1, 2, 3 in men's and women's for the slopestyle. Can afford no mistakes. Took a third in the halfpipe. He's already medaled. But so far, the Finn is in third. Stylish off the first kicker. Second one is what's going to define him here, though. Three massive rotations. That's a 1080. Styled out as well. He's left everything out there. But have the Russians gone too big? This bump's all round. What a contest.
Oh, look at this, jumps, ladies and gentlemen. Nice grip, nice landing. A small touch of snow, a little touch of snow. But we hope the referees will be kind to him.
Slight hand drag on the landing. He's happy with the way that he's completed his run. He's done everything he can. But do the judges reward him here? Team Finland have been representing well throughout this competition. Already taken a bronze. Northern Europe looking to podium again here. Three big Russian scores to beat, though. Anticipation. Have Russia taken all six medals from the soccer cluster here at the slopestyle? There's only one man who can stop the Russian party, and that's the one in your picture. Some of the crowd just can't watch. The judges need to see where this score fits in. They have to be thorough. They have to make sure that the riders are rewarded. He's celebrating because he takes his second bronze, 89.25. He goes above Mikhail Matveyev, and Finland are on the podium again here. But it's gold for Anton Mamiev. Vlad Harderin takes the silver. What a contest. There, the result of the men's final. What a day for Anton Mamiev. There he will remember. Vlad Harderin takes the silver. Axel Tellen third. But all performers have produced their best here at the Sopka cluster. The venue is the gift that just keeps giving. But that's all we've got time for. From Krasnoyarsk 2019, we will see you again very soon.